Hey everyone, welcome to Diet.com Video. I'm Sarah, your host, and today we're going to be taking a look at the most recent studies that were conducted by some of the finest medical institutes. Now, I say that with a little bit of sarcasm because it seems like every time I turn on the TV, the news is reporting a new study, but they're just reporting information that I learned in college. Basically, standard stuff that we all pretty much know from common sense. So today we're going to take a look at these little gems of science, I guess. The first study comes from Harvard University. The professors wanted to see if a female teenager's self-perception of her social status had any effect on her weight. So they went and got 4,500 girls, asked them what their BMI index was, and then asked themselves to rank on a scale of 1 to 10 what they felt their social status was after reading this question. At the top of the ladder are the people in your school with the most respect and highest standing. At the bottom are the people who no one respects and no one wants to hang out with or hang around with. Where would you place yourself on this ladder? Well, the researchers caught up with these girls 2 years later, and guess what? They all gained weight. Yes, weird adolescence, 2 years and boom, they blossom. The girls they found out who ranked themselves as a 4 or lower were more likely to gain weight than the girls who thought they were like a 9 or 10. Obviously, they're really good at dieting. Kidding. But in conclusion, popular girls gain less weight than those who perceive themselves as not as cool on the social ladder. In other news regarding popular kids, they're also more likely to do drugs, drink, and get in trouble with the law for little misdemeanors. The next story we're going to take a look at had sorority girls running to the tanning beds. A bunch of local news stations were carrying a story that made it seem like the sun was actually good for you rather than what we all previously thought, sunburns, skin cancer. Apparently, vitamin D helps prevent heart disease. As you probably already know, vitamin D can be absorbed through a little sun exposure. But before you go running for the tanning booth, you can actually get your daily dose of vitamin D with just 10 minutes outside in the sun without wearing sunscreen. But the researchers all make precautions that don't think that the sun won't harm your skin. Just a little bit is good for you. And with that said, we already knew that, I think, 5 years ago. But keep up the good work, researchers. Lastly, our third study comes from overseas in England. The British Medical Association Journal has reported that excessive sugarless gum chewing may cause similar side effects to the FDA diet pill Ally. It turns out that sorbitol, the key ingredient in sugarless gum and other sugar-free sweets, actually has laxative properties. Now, I've never heard these findings before, but for some reason I have a bad feeling in my stomach that they probably should have released the results with minimal press. I feel like these are gonna end up on some Pro Anna website message board. Maybe it's just me. But if you are interested in this study, if you have 20 or more sticks of sugar-free gum, you may experience diarrhea and severe weight loss. You should also probably go to your chiropractor or dentist to get your TMJ checked out. But that's it for today. If you guys see any weird medical studies being done that you think were done about 5 or 10 years ago, or you think just are unnecessary for us to know more about, send them to us, let us know. Hope you guys like this segment, and we'll see you next time.